of the HBO Chernobyl miniseries, because who wouldn't? Very good acting, immersive music, perfect catchphrases that stayed with the community for a long time, and this grim but very hopeful atmosphere. Yet, as always, even the biggest star has some flaws. The director and the writer had to add some changes, and also some new things to the story. Not because it wasn't good enough, but to have some sidekicks that would help to introduce us, the viewers, to the plot more interestingly. So today we will speak about the HBO Chernobyl miniseries, about what happened, about what went wrong, and what was actually right. This episode will have many parts, as there is much to be told. But having in mind that the last time we introduced the first part of Valery Legasov's story, you may catch the link in the upper right corner, let's start with some fact-checking about his character in the TV series first. So the very first question, was Valery Legasov an actual expert on the RBMK reactors? You may know it from the previous video on our channel, but to those who didn't watch it, long story short, no, he wasn't. He was indeed an expert on nuclear energy though. After all, he was one of the most important people at the Kurchatov Institute of Atomic Energy. He knew a lot about nuclear fission, nuclear fuel, radioactive materials or radiation. But nonetheless, he wasn't specifically the best specialist when it came down to that kind of the reactor. This doesn't mean that he wasn't the good person to do the job that he was given at the Chernobyl, so to reduce the damage done by the disaster. Many witnesses and experts said that thanks to him, the outcome of the whole disaster was greatly reduced. Of course, this wasn't only Legasov's achievement, as thousands of people worked hard to manage the disaster. As for the TV miniseries, this fact is represented in some way by Uliana Komiuk, who pointed the HBO Legasov in the right direction in one of the first episodes. The second question. Was Valery Legasov's home, so his apartment, accurately pictured? So that's the tricky one, because there is no good answer to that. The short one would be no, they didn't portray his apartment accurately. But it's kind of complicated. We can definitely say Legasov wasn't just a regular persona, like, for example, a lower-rank policeman or a factory worker. He was one of the best experts on nuclear energy in the whole Soviet Union. He also had an important job at the Kurchatov Institute. So, long story short, his apartment probably should have been better equipped, or even just looking more nicely than, for example, fireman Ignatenko's apartment in Pripyat. And there were many differences between the two apartments, or even clothing, between those two people. However, the HBO miniseries depicts the Soviet Union in the most accurate way in the whole Western-made movie business so far. It still misses something that we could call a deep Soviet-like experience. There were significant divisions between socioeconomic classes, despite the proud USSR trying to tell everybody no such divisions existed. The third question. Were Boris Shcherbina and Valery Legasov actually friends? And that's one of the biggest surprises I have ever had. There is actually no background, no evidence to tell that Boris Shcherbina and Valery Legasov were friends. No colleagues of theirs said anything about it, there were no recordings. The only thing we could classify as such is just one photo of the two of them looking at each other and smiling. Seriously, that's it. The bond they have made through the HBO miniseries was just an interpretation of the people behind the series. The creator of the show, Craig Mazin, said in one interview that exactly this mentioned photo was the inspiration behind portraying two characters as close friends, working together to harness the outcome of the atomic disaster. It seemed very natural, and to be totally honest, it kind of worked with the whole picture. I imagined them being friends as a viewer of the series, especially having in mind what they'd gone through together there. Of course, that would be the case if the HBO Chernobyl miniseries story was 100% accurate. But it's not. At least we know that Shcherbina and Legasov were rather kind towards each other. But many scenes where they talk privately and honestly about their feelings, their fears, their jobs, are just pure imagination. This was of great use when it comes down to thickening the plot of the TV series and adding some human touch. But again, not real, unfortunately. Or at least, as far as we can tell. Fourth question. How many people actually died immediately after the Chernobyl disaster happened. Despite HBO miniseries being pretty accurate in general, some things were enhanced to tell the story better, in a more sensational manner. The Chernobyl miniseries makes us think that at least few people died during or just after the reactor 4 explosion. However, we won't ever be able to tell for sure. The best source that we can quote is the United Nations official report. This document states that two people died in the first hours of the whole incident, because of the explosion itself, not the radiation. One of them that was also portrayed in the miniseries was Valery Legasov, a power plant operator that most probably was killed immediately during the explosion. As I said, we can't be 100% sure, because if that was the case, his body is buried under the reactor 4 building and the sarcophagus too. The second man was supposed to die due to extreme burns as a result of the fire that broke out. And what about the other victims? It took about 2 weeks after the reactor exploded for the first responders to start dying, including two women working at the power plant at the day of the disaster. Despite what you may think, the radiation was not the worst problem they had, and it wasn't also the most immediate one. At that time, with, for example, firefighters coming to the hospital. For example, having in mind the firefighters, around 2/3 of them had burns, like intense, really dangerous to their lives burns because of the fires that broke out. At least 6 died only because of that reason, as the UN document revealed. And the burns were the issue that often had to be addressed first. Or at least as quickly as the other injuries, depending on the state of the particular responder. There is also something called ARS, or acute radiation syndrome, which can be roughly explained as a severe illness due to intake of high radiation doses. And however many men died because of this syndrome, around 70-80% who suffered ARS survived. However, we like the HBO miniseries a lot. There are some things that can be misleading in some way. The whole picture was pretty much accurate, but we would rather make sure that you know the true story of Chernobyl, not enriched in any way just to sound better. So, what do you think? Do you like this kind of videos? If yes, please leave a comment and share this episode, for example with your friends. Also, we will continue the stories that we began in the previous videos, and also we will introduce you to the new ones. If you would like to check the other videos that I just mentioned, look for the playlist called Chernobyl Stories on our channel. Having in mind the time that we are publishing this video, we wanted to wish you all a Merry Christmas. See you next week, and stay safe, guys.